Thanks for joining us. Late today, 10 more people were charged in federal court, accused of stealing millions of dollars as part of the Feeding Our Future COVID scandal.
That brings the total number of defendants to 70 in what prosecutors call the largest pandemic-related fraud in the country. Lou Ragusa has been on this case from the beginning and is here with a new development. Lou?
Julian Rainey, it's been almost a year since the last charges were filed in the Feeding Our Future case, but they told us to be expecting more, and the new allegations involve multiple family members allegedly conspiring together.
The former Evergreen Grocery and Deli on Nicollet Avenue in Minneapolis was approved to operate as a federal child nutrition program site sponsored by the nonprofit Feeding Our Future in July 2020. But according to a federal indictment unsealed today, even before its application was approved, the owner of Evergreen and his wife claimed to be serving thousands of meals to children. At one point, fraudulently claiming to serve more than 3,000 meals twice a day, 7 days a week. They're accused of receiving $4.2 million and using it to buy a house in New Hope, luxury items, and sending $2.5 million of that money overseas. A second unsealed indictment charges seven people with crimes like wire fraud, federal programs bribery, and money laundering. Copies of several alleged phony meal count sheets are attached to the indictment, which says the defendants, many of whom are related, created shell companies to make fake claims of meals served to children, paying each other for food that didn't exist. The new court documents say Feeding Our Future executive director Amy Bach oversaw the massive scheme, and she is implicated in helping all of the new defendants carry out their alleged fraud.
The new defendants are scheduled to be in court tomorrow. One of them, however, has indicated that she will plead guilty in April. 17 of the 70 defendants that have been charged have pleaded guilty already. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Lou.